Our evolution is deeply connected to heat. Fire was our first great technology. With the flame, we chased out the cold, cooked food, and sought colder climates. We soon used fire to forge tools and drive industry. Today, we burn fuel to create steam and generate electricity. But burning things for energy is creating a crisis. We must urgently reduce emissions to avert climate change, yet our energy demand is rising. I know what you're thinking. We're screwed. But the answer is closer than you think. Beneath our feet, just a few kilometers down, lies an infinite supply of energy that can sustain us for thousands of years. The Earth's internal heat, geothermal energy, is our next energy revolution. Who here has been to a natural hot spring? Glorious, isn't it? If you've ever made the mistake of going with me, you'll have heard the whole story. How the Earth's core, surrounded by liquid iron and a magmatic mantle, burns at 5,000 degrees Celsius. Heat remnant from the Earth's formation billions of years ago. That heat has nowhere to escape but through the Earth's surface. And the soothing waters have carried this heat through a network of bedrock to the pools we bask in, a rare signature of our Earth's ancient story. I've long been captivated by the Earth's internal power. As a child visiting the Royal Ontario Museum, I spent hours immersed in the volcano exhibit. The hypnotic power of the magma within revealed the forces that move continents, shape mountains, and create oceans. That fascination stayed with me throughout my teenage years as the environmentalists started to wake up. And those two parts of me have been strong allies ever since. Now, I'm an earth scientist, or as my brother calls me, a rock doctor. I've explored for geothermal all over the world, from the Andes to Japan, from northern BC to Antarctica. Geothermal can truly be found anywhere. But let's think about the Earth as a whole. The Earth's crust is, at most, 1% of the Earth's total diameter, equivalent to the skin of an apple. Beneath that apple skin lies an infinite supply of heat. Now, I won't whisper sweet nothings to you about kilojoules or thermal diffusion, but the amount of heat contained in the top 10 kilometers of the Earth's crust could supply our current global energy needs for over 200 million years. This is the promise of geothermal energy. So, back to the human scale. If geothermal holds so much potential, why is it so often overlooked? In short, economics. Today, harnessing geothermal energy has high upfront costs. But the power itself is very inexpensive, so those upfront costs take years to make back. That is a hard sell in a world well adjusted to lucrative sources of power. But the costs of geothermal are already coming down with just a few feats of engineering as we master our methods of capturing it. This is generally done in two ways. Let's start small. Your house. The first method, geoexchange, is a series of underground pipes that run, at most, a couple hundred meters deep beneath your dwelling. In winter, the pipes pull heat out of the ground and into your house. In the summer, the system reverses, cooling your house. They work great, but they're pricey, perhaps adding a year to your mortgage. The return, however, is up to 65% savings on your energy bill and an equal amount of energy spared. Imagine the energy we could save if we just put our heating systems in the ground. Let's scale up. The second method is turning geothermal heat into electricity. Just like a coal or gas plant, a geothermal plant uses heat to create steam to spin a turbine. But rather than burning fossil fuels for heat, these plants circulate steam and hot water from deep underground aquifers. Their footprint is small, and they supply clean, constant, renewable electricity. This is a tried and true method of power generation, commonly found in places such as Iceland, Indonesia, Kenya, and the Western United States. But the catch is, these aquifers don't exist everywhere. They're only found in specific regions in the world. One of them being here in British Columbia, by the way. This brings us to the geothermal frontier. Doing this anywhere. Creating these underground aquifers where they don't exist. All over the world, scientists and engineers are tackling this challenge. And it's a wild scene. Experimental wells have been drilled into magma chambers in Iceland. Groundbreaking pilot projects are ongoing in the USA. In Slovakia, they're testing plasma beams to drill down to 10 kilometers. But even with these strides, we've barely scratched the surface. In 2023, global investment in geothermal tech was $2 billion. Wind power received $200 billion. With that amount of funding, geothermal could have 400 full-scale active demonstration projects. We currently have 4. Geothermal isn't failing us. We are failing geothermal. We need to try harder. Solving this puzzle means we can access the heat inside the apple skin globally, whether in an urban center in Africa or remote diesel-dependent community in northern Canada. The International Energy Agency recently concluded that geothermal could account for 15% of global power supply by 2050. Blend that with other renewables, and we're really starting to make a dent in things. In the 1850s, the discovery of underground kerosene launched the petroleum trade. It required drilling with, to our eyes, crude and laborious technologies. Yet the discovery led to enormous strides of human innovation. And within only a century, we were using this energy to explore outer space. Our collective creativity and brilliance has found no limit, and we haven't now. We can dig some holes. We can transfer our decades of knowledge from the oil and gas sector and unlock geothermal. We can pierce the apple skin and solve our energy crisis. It will take bold and high-risk ventures to unleash the Earth's internal power. But to go to a new place, we have to walk an uncharted road. All we need to know is our destination. A world where energy is harvested from vast resources of underground heat. It will no longer poison our atmosphere, leading to droughts, floods, and fires. It will always be on, regardless of weather, and available anywhere. And it will sustain us for thousands of generations to come. That is our return on investment. So let's integrate geo-exchange systems into every new build. Harness the geothermal reservoirs that are within reach. And dare to delve deeper and hotter and unleash a new era of clean energy security. Just as those who first braved the flame and changed the course of history, we too can leave a legacy. We can be the spark that lights the world in the bright fires of geothermal power. Thank you.